Hi friends, welcome to Crack UPSC CSE with India's largest online learning platform, that is Unacademy. This is Kiran and Shetty, Faculty for Political Science, Public Administration, Quality, Issues in Governance and Ethics. Today we are going to discuss very, very important topic, that is analysis of Parliament from mains perspective. Not only for mains, we will also discuss the facts which are very pertinent for prelims as well. Always remember, friends, Parliament is one of the favorite areas of, what you say, examiner in mains as well as in prelims. In our last session, we discussed about the devices of Parliament, which are very, very important for prelims. In this class, we will discuss the topic of Parliament from mains as well as prelims perspective. What you will get from Unacademy? You will get daily live classes, live tests, quizzes, structured courses, unlimited access to videos on UPSC prelims and mains. You can prepare with top educators such as Mrunal Patel, Roman Saini. You will be getting videos on UPSC prelims as well as mains subjects such as Polity, Economy, History, Geography, Ethics, etc. You can subscribe Unacademy Plus for 12 months. It is 44,000. If you use my promo code, that is capital KIRAN, you will get 10% discount. And if you subscribe for 24 months, it will be all the more good for you, because just at 64,000, you can get 24 months subscription. And in that also, you will get 10% discount if you use my promo code, that is capital KIRAN. Academy has recently come up with a novel and frequent subscription, that is iconic subscription, in which you will get personal mentorship, which is very, very important for the aspirant. You will have personal mentorship, daily mains questions and answers, study planner, personalized feedback, and unlimited practice. Friends, please subscribe Unacademy Iconic subscription. For 12 months, it is 57,600. You will get 10% discount if you use my promo code. And for 24 months, it is 89,100. Friends, first we will discuss in this session, what are the provisions related to money bill? Article 110, Article 110 defines money bill. Money bill means the bill which comprises all or some or any of the provisions that have been mentioned in Article 110 exclusively. Money bill is that bill which comprises exclusively all or some or any provisions mentioned in Article 110. What are they? We will discuss. Imposition, abolition, remission or alteration or regulation of any tax. Imposition or abolition, remission, alteration or regulation of any tax. The regulation of borrowing of money by union government and by union government, the custody of Consolidated Fund of India and Contingency Fund of India, appropriation of money out of Consolidated Fund of India, declaration of any expenditure charged on Consolidated Fund of India, or increasing the amount of any such expenditure. What does it mean? Declaration of any new expenditure which is going to be charged upon Consolidated Fund of India, or increasing the amount that has already been charged upon Consolidated Fund of India. What is the difference between money made from Consolidated Fund of India and money charged upon Consolidated Fund of India? What is the difference? The difference, friends. What is the difference between money charged upon Consolidated Fund of India and money made from Consolidated Fund of India? Money made from Consolidated Fund of India means that particular amount has to be voted by Lok Sabha. But on the other hand, the expenditure that is charged upon Consolidated Fund of India means that particular expenditure will not be voted by Lok Sabha. It doesn't require voting of Lok Sabha. Doesn't require the voting of Lok Sabha. That is, expenditure charged upon Consolidated Fund of India. Expenditure made from Consolidated Fund of India, which requires voting by Lok Sabha. Why the constitution makers provided the expenditure to be charged on Consolidated Fund of India? What would be the reason? The reason is there are some important constitutional functionaries such as the president, then the judges of Supreme Court, the chairman and members of UPSC, Comptroller and Auditor General of India. While performing their duties and functions, sometimes their unbiased duties may go against the government of the day. Their unbiased duties, their discharge of unbiased duties sometimes may go against the government of the day. For instance, Vinod Rai, the former Comptroller and Auditor General of India, he submitted many reports which indicted the former UPA government, UPA 2 government especially, because of which UPA 2 government blamed in the eyes of public, which was ultimately resulted in the defeat of UPA government in 2014 election. In the same way, in 2014, when Modi government came to power, immediately it legislated NJAC bill, National Judicial Appointment Commission bill. That bill was struck down by Supreme Court, saying that it is against basic feature of the constitution. So this decision of Supreme Court was against the government of the day. In such instances, the government, in order to take a kind of vengeance or vendetta, it may stop salaries and the expenditure of these important constitutional functionaries and these important constitutional offices. Yes. Ours is parliamentary form of government. The government is in chair, it is in power because it has majority in Lok Sabha. Since it has majority in Lok Sabha, it may prevent voting on such vital expenditure which may ultimately stifle the functioning of these constitutional functionaries and offices. In order to relieve from such kind of danger, our constitution makers provided this provision, the expenditure to be charged on Consolidated Fund of India. The expenditure to be charged upon Consolidated Fund of India. Or any expenditure, increasing any expenditure that has already been charged upon consolidated fund. Then the audit of accounts of union or of a state, the manner in which the audit of the union is conducted or a state is conducted, or any matter incidental to any of the matters specified above. All these provisions are mentioned in Article 110. Any bill which comprises all these provisions, or some of these provisions, or any of these provisions, exclusively, time and again I am repeating, be careful with the UPSC. The wording is very important in the exam. You will be under the pressure of the exam, and you may tend to overlook such kind of vital words. Some or all or any provisions exclusively. That means they only be mentioned in the bill, not any other matter of legislation. Then features of money bill. It requires prior assent of the president. It needs to be first introduced in Lok Sabha. It should be introduced by minister member only. Remember, it should be introduced by a minister member only. It cannot be rejected or amended by Rajya Sabha. Its defeat in Lok Sabha leads to fall of the government. Always distinguish between money bill and ordinary. Money bill and constitutional amendment bill. It requires prior assent of the president. It needs to be first introduced in Lok Sabha. It should be introduced by a minister member. It cannot be rejected or amended by Rajya Sabha. If it is defeated in Lok Sabha, leads to fall of the government. With regard to constitutional amendment bill, constitutional amendment bill doesn't require prior assent of the president. Second, it can be introduced in either house of the parliament. Third, it need not to be introduced by minister member only. As soon as constitutional amendment, the word is said, we tend to make a mistake that it has to be introduced only by minister member. Oh no, even private member can introduce it. Then the speaker certifies whether the bill is money bill or not, and speaker's decision in this regard is final. Speaker's decision in this regard is final, and the president cannot return the money bill for reconsideration. President cannot return the bill for reconsideration, and speaker ultimately certifies whether a bill is money bill or not, and his decision in this regard will be final. Then financial bill type A, it is not mentioned in the constitution. It is for our simpler understanding. Financial bill, Article 117, Provision 1, Type A. It comprises all or any or some of the provisions mentioned in Article 110 along with any matter of general legislation. It comprises all or any or some of the provisions mentioned in Article 110 along with any matter of general legislation. It requires, that means, it will also comprises the provisions mentioned in Article 110. But the difference between money bill and financial bill type A is that financial bill type A consists of the provisions in Article 110 along with any matter of general legislation. I'm sorry. along with Article 110 Financial Bill Type A that has been mentioned in Article 117 Provision 1. It is like money bill. It comprises any or all or some of the provisions mentioned in Article 110. But along with that, it will also consist of any matter of general legislation. What are the similarities between money bill and financial bill type A? It requires prior assent of the president and it should be introduced in, it should first introduced in Lok Sabha. I'm sorry, here there is a typing mistake. It should be first introduced in Lok Sabha. But it can be rejected are amended by Rajya Sabha, that is financial bill type A. Financial bill type B, which has been mentioned in Article 117 Provision 3, it just involves expenditure from Consolidated Fund of India, but it doesn't include any of the matters mentioned in Article 110. It's just, what you say, it involves expenditure from Consolidated Fund of India, but it does not include any matter that is mentioned in Article 110. It is like ordinary bill only, but only the difference is that before it is being passed by any house, whether it is Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, it requires the assent of the president. So before being passed by Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, in which it is introduced, it requires the assent of the president. So here, it is very important for the examination. Remember, the differences, the similarities between money bill and financial bill type A, which has been mentioned in Article 117 Provision 1, are that, like money bill, financial bill type A comprises any or all or some of the matters that have been mentioned in Article 110. That is one. Second, it requires the prior assent of the president. Third, it ought to be introduced first in Lok Sabha. These are the similarities. The differences are that, along with the provisions mentioned in Article 110, financial bill type A consists of any matter of general legislation. For instance, Telangana bifurcation. Along with Telangana bifurcation, some provision that has been mentioned in Article 110 has been clubbed. That is financial bill type A. But whereas in money bill, purely it consists of the provisions in Article 110. The differences between money bill and financial bill type A, consists of any matter of general legislation first. Second, it can be amended or rejected by Rajya Sabha. Then financial bill type B that has been mentioned in Article 117 Provision 3. It is like ordinary bill only, but it has to get assent from the president before it is being passed by Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, wherever it has been introduced. Then now we will discuss about joint sitting of two houses. In following circumstances, joint sitting will be summoned. If the other house rejects the bill altogether, if the two houses disagree on the amendments, for instance, Lok Sabha passed a bill, then that has been sent to Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha proposed some amendments to that bill, but Lok Sabha does not agree for those amendments. So if the two houses disagree on amendments, if more than 6 months have elapsed from the date of the receipt of the bill by the other house, joint sitting will be called. And joint sitting will not be called for Constitutional Amendment Acts and money bills. Always remember, joint sitting will not be called for Constitutional Amendment Bills and Money Bills. And as we know, joint sitting will be presided over by Speaker of Lok Sabha, not by Vice President. It is presided over by Speaker of Lok Sabha. Now, in these instances, Lok Sabha has more powers than Rajya Sabha. In these instances, Lok Sabha has more powers than Rajya Sabha. What are they? Money bill, revocation of national emergency. Always remember, friends, this provision has been incorporated by 44th Amendment Act. That is, the national emergency can be revoked by Lok Sabha if 1/10 members of Lok Sabha gives written recommendation to the speaker. 1/10 members of Lok Sabha give written recommendation to the speaker that in order to discuss whether to revoke the national emergency or not, special session of Lok Sabha ought to be summoned. If 1/10 members of Lok Sabha give written recommendation to the speaker requesting special session ought to be summoned to discuss whether to continue the national emergency or not, then the speaker does not have any discretion. He has to summon special session of Lok Sabha in order to discuss whether to revoke the national emergency or to continue national emergency. Here, one more thing. In order to pass the promulgation of national emergency, it requires 2/3 majority. In order to pass the promulgation of national emergency, it requires 2/3 majority. But 2/3 majority of the members present and voting, or majority of total strength of the house, whichever is higher. So that is special majority. Special majority is required to pass or to give or to ratify the national emergency in both the houses of parliament. It requires special majority. But to revoke, just simple majority is required, that too in Lok Sabha. It requires simple majority. So this provision was introduced by 44th Amendment Act. In order to discuss whether to revoke the national emergency or not, 1/10 members of Lok Sabha give written recommendation to Speaker. The Speaker has to summon. He has to summon the special session of Lok Sabha to discuss whether to continue the national emergency or not. Then third, no confidence motion. In this regard also, Lok Sabha has upper hand over Rajya Sabha. No confidence motion. If it is passed with simple majority, Council of Ministers has to resign. Then adjournment motion can also be introduced only in Lok Sabha. It cannot be introduced in Rajya Sabha. Then financial bill type A that has been incorporated in Article 117 Provision 1. Financial bill type A ought to be first introduced in Lok Sabha. In what way, with regard to joint sitting, Lok Sabha has more powers than Rajya Sabha? In two respects, Lok Sabha has more powers than Rajya Sabha with regard to joint sitting. What are these two instances? They are First joint sitting will be presided over by the speaker. The joint sitting will be presided over by speaker. And joint sitting means what? The members of Lok Sabha and members of Rajya Sabha, they will be sitting together and they will be voting on the bill together as a whole. Both the members of both the houses clubbed together, they vote on the bill. In that case, what happens? Since the number of Lok Sabha is more than Rajya Sabha, invariably the opinion of Lok Sabha will prevail with regard to passage of that particular bill. The total strength of Lok Sabha is 544. On the other hand, total strength of Rajya Sabha is 245. Because of this numerical strength, invariably, the opinion of Lok Sabha will prevail over that of Rajya Sabha with regard to the passage of ordinary bill in case of joint sitting. That's why, if you remember, in the initial years when Modi government came to power, it used to have very, very less majority in Rajya Sabha. Now, because of its BJP winning UP elections and other state elections, now the strength in Lok Sabha has been improved for the ruling party in recent times. In those days, it used to be very less. Modi government thought of passing many bills by summoning joint session. In that context, former President of India, Pranab Mukherjee, cautioned the government should not, think of passing as many bills under joint session. Pass maximum number of bills by summoning joint sitting is not prudent in parliamentary form of government, overlooking the importance of Rajya Sabha. In these two instances, Lok Sabha has more powers than Rajya Sabha with regard to joint sitting, with regard to presiding officer, that is speaker, who presides over the joint sitting. Second, because of the numerical strength of Lok Sabha, the opinion of Lok Sabha will prevail over that of Rajya Sabha. Then with regard to passage of budget, after the stage of general discussion, the role of Rajya Sabha will be no more in passage of budget. Hence, with regard to passage of budget also, Lok Sabha has more powers than Rajya Sabha. Now we will discuss the instances where Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha have equal status. What are they? Passage of ordinary bill, passage of constitutional amendment bills. At least with regard to passage of ordinary bill, if it is rejected by Rajya Sabha or Rajya Sabha does not take any action on the bill for 6 months, joint sitting can be called. With regard to the passage of constitutional amendment acts, once it is rejected by Rajya Sabha, it is the death of the bill. It is the death of the bill. Passage of constitutional amendment bills. Then third, election and impeachment of the president. Election and impeachment of the president. In this instance also, both Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha have equal status. Then election of vice president. But remember, with regard to election of vice president, the members of both the houses of parliament participate. But with regard to removal of vice president from the office, that removal motion should first only be introduced in Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha has to pass that removal proposal with absolute majority. Absolute majority means majority of total strength of the house. We will have one 10 minutes session in this respect with regard to the various types of majority. What is simple majority? What is absolute majority? What is special majority? Then impeachment of important constitutional functionaries such as the Chief Justice of India, judges of Supreme Court and etc. Both Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha have equal status. Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha have equal status. Approval of emergencies. With regard to approval of emergencies also, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha have equal status. These facts are very important, friends. Either in prelims or in mains, they can be asked. In 2014 mains, they asked, in what instances Rajya Sabha has more powers than Lok Sabha? What are the instances in which Rajya Sabha has more powers than Lok Sabha? So these things are very important, these three things. The instances where Lok Sabha has more powers than Rajya Sabha. Second, the instances in which both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha have equal status. Third, the instances where Lok Sabha, Rajya Sabha has more powers than Lok Sabha. Then consideration of reports of Finance Commission, UPSC, etc. Then enlargement of jurisdiction of Supreme Court and UPSC. Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha have equal status. Now, very, very important one. The instances in which Rajya Sabha has more powers than Lok Sabha. What are they? Rajya Sabha can empower the parliament to legislate on state subjects. Rajya Sabha can empower parliament to legislate on state subjects. Rajya Sabha can empower the parliament to legislate on state subjects. Article 249. In center-state relations, anyhow, we are going to study in which instances the parliament can legislate on state subjects. In special circumstances in which the parliament can legislate on state subjects. So this is one among them. For Article 249, the Rajya Sabha can empower the parliament to legislate on state subjects. Then, creation of more number of All India Services. Creation of more number of All India Services. Under Article 312, the Rajya Sabha can create more number of All India Services. As of now, we have three All India Services: Indian Administrative Service, Indian Police Service, Indian Forest Service. These three services we have. And more number of All India Services can be created by Rajya Sabha. What is the significance of All India Services? Members of All India Services, they can serve both at center as well as at state level. Generally, in pure federations such as US, Australia, the union government will be having its own separate civil services. The states will be having their own separate civil services. It is one of the unique features of our constitution that we have all the institution of All India Services, members of which be serving both at center as well as at state. And as we discussed in earlier instance, under Article 67B, the impeachment motion against Vice President can only be first introduced in Rajya Sabha. And it ought to be passed by Rajya Sabha with absolute majority. In these three instances, Rajya Sabha has more powers than Lok Sabha. Thank you, friends. Please use my promo code, that is capital KIRAN, to get 10% discount. And if you like this PPTs, please subscribe this link, post Telegram link. Thank you. Thanks a lot. See you in the next session with more interesting and important topic. Thanks.